Using PBR materials in your workflow is really helpful to achieving photorealistic render in less time and effort. In a previous video, I talked about the concept of PBR and how to use them. In another video, I showed you the best websites to get free, high-quality PBR materials. And now, in this video, we are going to see how to load PBR materials quickly and use them in V-Ray or Corona Render. Hey, what's up guys, hope you are all doing well. If you are new here, I do videos about architecture design and visualization. So if you are interested, consider subscribing and turn on the bell so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Alright, now let's see how to load any PBR materials with just a few clicks and seconds. Keep in mind that I am going to use a script and it's not free. It costs around $15, but it's worth it in my opinion. This is not a sponsored video, just a script that I used a lot and I find it very useful. So now without further ado, let's start the tutorial. Okay, so in the beginning, from where you can get a high quality PBR materials? I already done videos about them. The first video I talked about the concept of PBR materials and all its resources, including paid and free resources. The second video I talked about only the top 5 websites for free PBR textures and materials. So definitely check them out before starting this video. Let's see an example for the PBR resources. So the first website is Texture Haven. This is a free website and you can get high quality PBR material for free. To get any material, just click on it and download all the maps, which include diffuse, displacement, normal, etc. This is a free website. A paid website is like CGX's, which they have a huge collection of PBR materials in high quality. You can buy the material separately or as a collection. And you can get a free sample by going to free collections and you will get up to 11 gigabytes of free 3D models, PBR textures and HDRI images. So now this is the resources for the PBR. What about the script? You need to get the material texture loader script, which is also not free, it's paid, but it's really useful and easy to use. Now let's go to 3ds Max and see how to install the script. Inside 3ds Max, go to scripting and choose run script. Go to the location that you have downloaded the script into and choose the last version of it. So in my case, I will choose 1.24 and hit open. Now you get something like this. We need to put it as an icon in the toolbar. So go to customize, custom user interface, go to toolbars and select the category name as DMZ, drag and drop material texture loader into the toolbar. Now we will get the icon for the material texture loader. Okay, let's see an example on how to use the script. This script supports V-Ray, Corona, Redshift, Arnold, F-Storm, physical and standard materials, and it's compatible with 3ds Max from version 2016 up to 2020. So keep that in mind. Now let's open our scene. This is a V-Ray scene. Now let's say that we want to change the material of the floor. So go directly to Material Texture Loader. Click on it. Now select Load Textures to load all the new textures. If you download any PBR material, you will get something like this, a preview for the material and all the supported textures. So select all the textures except of course the preview and hit open. And now the script will put all the textures in the correct channel. For example, diffuse in diffuse, normal in normal, height as a displacement map, etc. Now select the render engine. So if you are using V-Ray, choose V-Ray. If you are using Corona, choose Corona. In my case, I will choose V-Ray and hit create material. You can rename the material and hit OK. Now open the material editor and drag the material from the material texture loader to the material editor as an instance. And that's it. Now you get your material. So let's assign it to the object. And let's see it in the render. So hit render. And I got this blown up floor. Why? Because I didn't add a V-Ray displacement mode into the floor. So this happened only in V-Ray. In Corona, you don't need to add a Corona displacement unless you want to. But in V-Ray, if you add any material with displacement, such as this material, if you can see in the
maps. We have a displacement map. So you need to add a V-Ray displacement mode to control the amount of displacement. So go to modify and add V-Ray displacement mode. Now you can change the amount as you like. In my case, this is 1 millimeter. I'll put it as 5 millimeter. And I will re-render the scene. And let's see the result. Okay, the render had finished. And as you can see, the material looks good and it gets all the reflections and displacement and all the other effects. And of course, if you need to increase the reflection or decrease it, you can go back to the material and change all the parameters that you want. Now let's go to a corona scene and see how to load the textures. This is a corona scene, so let's repeat the steps. Also, let's go back to the script material texture loader. And let's go to load textures and choose all the textures. Hit open. Now change the render engine to corona and hit create material. Okay. Now open the material editor. Drag and drop the material to the material editor as an instance and assign it directly to the floor. And as you can see, the floor have no corona displacement modifier or anything, only the material. Now let's hit render and see our result. And this is the result in corona render. Okay, so the big difference between V-Ray and corona. So in V-Ray, you need to add V-Ray displacement mode, but keep in mind to check use object material in the 3D mapping and subdivision. Use object material to ensure that the displacement modifier will use the displacement texture in the material or from the material. Now finally, let's see how to save our material to use it in another projects. Let's close our render. Let's go to the material editor. And I know that a lot of you guys use the compact material editor, but the slight material editor has also a really nice features, such as the view. You can add views and add a lot of materials to every view. And you can also open a preview window and put it in here, so you can see a preview of your material while you are working. And this works for a lot of materials. Okay, but to save your material, let's go to mode, compact material editor. Now let's see how to save this material. Okay, so go to get material and from here choose new material library, select a path for the material and also name it and hit save. Now we have a library, but it's empty. Let's add our material. So let's select an empty slot, go to pick material, pick it from scene. Now hit save material or put to library and choose the library that you have created. Give it a name. Okay. And as a personal touch, you can change the color of the library. So right click, go to edit group color, change the color and hit okay. And by that you have identified the library that you have just created. And this library will stay in the 3ds Max. So every time that you are opening a new scene, you will find the materials that you have created. Let's say this material also we want to save. So just easily put it to library and choose the library name. And that's it. So in the next time, if you open a new scene, just go to the material editor and go to get material. And you will find your library here. And you can drag it and drop it directly to the objects or into the material editor. So that's everything about loading your PBR material directly to 3ds Max. I think I will make another video about the slate material editor and all the features in it. So make sure to subscribe so you don't miss that video.
And by that, we have reached to the end of this video. I hope you have enjoyed it and find it useful. If you do, smash the like button and share it with your friends. This will mean a lot to me and help the channel to grow. Leave a comment if you have another script to cover. That's it for this video. See you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.